For the first time, man walked the earth as a combine and shouted,
"My balls! Where are my balls? Why'd they have to get rid of them in the surgical procedure? I didn't sign up for this! Why? Why? What are you looking at?
Since the portal storms, the 7-hour war, and the enslavement of the human race by the Combine, ominous rumors have been privately circulating amongst the inhabitants of City 17 that this vast alien empire had been to work on what was darkly hinted as the ultimate weapon. A weapon so lethal it could be used against all life on Earth in retaliation to the growing citizens' rebellion. What they were planning, or why it should exist? No one could say.
Madrick, we're putting the base on condition red.
Good idea, sir. That should keep the garrison on their toes. The soldiers have been acting a bit strange lately.
Come on, get the water
out of here! Come on, Belch, right there! You knew!
Party guns not working. For some reason, I just...
Hey, asshole, you're going for that water, man! What's your problem?
So, this drill should be a good reality check for them, right?
This is no drill, Madrick. I've just received word of a major rebel sneak attack on many Combine installations all over the region.
Oh hell. Are we a likely target here, sir?
I don't know, but the base is going on condition red now.
Go, 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 go took all the ammo.
Sorry, guys, I didn't really mean to do that, I swear.
I also want you to issue this order to the 52nd Bomber Squadron. Wing attack plan R.
Here I come!
Here, you alright? Here, let me try and help you.
Sir, all of those targets are Combine military installations. Does friendly fire mean anything to you?
My orders are orders, Mandrake. And we're issuing them now.
Do you really think that the Rebels hit all of those targets?
Mandrake, it'd get even hairier if the Rebels were able to use our own weapons against us. I'm sure that is the reasoning behind it, so get busy.
Oh, all right. Yes, sir, I'll do it now.
Major Kong, I know you think this is crazy, but we just got a message from Control, and it decodes this Wing Attack Plan R.
Wing Attack Plan R? Goldie, how many times have I told you I don't want nobody horsing around on the airplane?
I'm not horsing around, sir. That's how it decodes.
Hold it. I'm coming back. Well, I guess this is it. Nuclear combat toe-to-toe with the Rebels.
You think this is for real? Sounds a lot like a drill to me.
Ain't nobody ever got this code before. And General Ripper wouldn't have issued it lest those Rebels hit the Citadel pretty hard and took control over some of the big-time Combine weaponry. Now, not much of a hand at making speeches. So I'm not gonna make one.
Let me play among the stars.
what spring was like.
Oh yeah, you like that, don't you?
That Jupiter and Mars.
Mr. Administrator.
What? What? What is it? What do you want?
You're needed in the war room. Something pretty serious is going on.
Oh, alright. Hey, you didn't see what I was doing, right?
No, Mr. Administrator. I didn't see you making sex poses with yourself in Gary's mod.
Good.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play among the stars. Do-do-do-do.
Pod, take me to the war room. Hey, no, not that way. The other way. Alright, close this thing up. Close this thing up. Go forward. Other way.
What? General Ripper ordered Plan R, and there's no rebel activity whatsoever? I'll be over in the war room faster than you can say, Cowabunga!
The rebel has no regard for humane society, and for this reason, men, I want to impress upon you the need for extreme watchfulness. The enemy may come individually, or he may come in strength. The rebels may even come in the uniform of our own troops. But however he comes, we must stop him. We must not allow him to gain entrance to this base. Now, I am going to give you three simple rules. First, trust no one, whatever his uniform or rank, unless he is known to you personally. Second, anyone or anything that approaches the perimeter is to be fired upon. Third, if in doubt, shoot first and ask questions afterwards. I would sooner accept a few casualties through accident than lose the entire base and its personnel with your carelessness. Soldiers, I have always expected the best from you, and you have never given me anything less than that.
What?
General Ripper, over and out.
There?
No.
Hey, pick up that can.
I don't trust you.
Ow! Why'd you shoot me?
What did you shoot him for?
He looks suspicious.
This is the attack profile. Target is the ICBM complex along the coast. We should be approaching it within the hour. Standard check procedure follows. Disable outside radio transmissions.
Outside radio transmissions disabled.
Switch all circuits to CRM transmission system.
All transmissions transferred to the CRM 114.
Check auto-destruct circuits.
Auto-destruct circuits checked.
Stash of beer at the ready.
Beer stash at the ready.
Isn't beer bad for your liver?
Liver? Where have you been? The liver was one of the first things to go during the surgical operation from human to combine.
Chocolate rain.
I said what in the butt?
Oh, what have I done?
You get rats. They get what they call lols.
Lols is a corruption of L-O-L, which stands for laugh out loud. Anonymous.
Sir,
big lols.
I've been listening to the Combine radio frequencies and I've heard nothing of any major rebel sneak attack, and I'm sure if there was something, rebels could not have gained control of the facilities being targeted. Heck, Combine television has been playing reruns of the Dr. Breen show.
You sure of that, Mandrake?
Yes, and as an executive officer under the Combine Overwatch, it is my clear duty under the present circumstances to issue and recall code upon my own authority and bring back the 52nd Bomber Squadron.
There's nothing anyone can do about it now, and nobody else knows the three-letter code to recall them.
Sir, but the Combine installations... The Combine could swiftly take them over again, could they not?
Do you suppose the Combine could take that chance? As of this moment, while we chat here so enjoyably, A decision is being made deep within the Citadel, and when they realize they cannot stop the Bomber Squadron, they will have to make a total commitment. We can win this war without the ridiculous use of nuclear and combined weaponry. We will fight every last Rebel soldier to soldier, like a big old game of Counter-Strike minus guarding the big green boxes, or a game of Battlefield 2 without the silly commander features. Once those Rebels hear that we've lost those installations, they'll immediately launch an all-out attack thinking that the Combine is an unorganized heap. But we will be ready, and the Rebellion will be crushed with one swift stroke. You and I both know the Rebels are well-armed and have been waiting for a chance to strike, and I'm going to give them one. We'll be waiting for them at the bomb sites, and we'll frag them all, one by one. I will no longer allow Rebel infiltration, Rebel warfare, Rebel indoctrination. And once that is taken care of, maybe we'll do something about Steve filling up my account with ads for games I never intend on buying!
Then you lied about those so-called orders you received. Why? Did you just make that part up?
To answer your questions in order, yes, and for the truly epic lulls, and duh.
Gentlemen, welcome to my underground war room. My name is Dr. Evil. Number 2, is everyone here?
Did you guys like my impression? That was from Austin Powers. Anyway, moving on.
Mr. Administrator, we've gathered everyone here as you requested. We got as many mod villain representatives as we could from Counter-Strike, Day of Defeat, Dystopia, The Hidden, Battlegrounds 2, Goldeneye Source. And then we also have Mr. Burns, Shadow from Sonic, Dr. Strangeman, and Hitler.
Hi.
Over there is General Turgidson, and he will explain the current situation.
Right. General Turgidson, what's going on here?
Mr. Administrator, about 20 minutes ago, General Jack Ripper, the commander of the primary Air Fleet Communications Outpost, issued an order to the dozen aircraft in his 52nd Bomber Squadron, which were located at an airbase outside of City 17, to converge into the city and attack major weapon installations in City 17, on the grounds that they were being overrun by significant Rebel forces. The planes are fully armed with nuclear weapons. We became aware of the situation here in the Citadel's war room, since all the military orders are run through here.
I understand that no sizable Rebel forces have been attacking any such targets.
No, sir.
Then why in the hell is this General Ripper attacking our own bases and combined super weapon installations? And how is he able to without getting any clearance from us?
It appears that General Ripper has a very bizarre reasoning backing his choice of orders, and he's exceeded his authority.
It certainly does. Far beyond the point that I imagined possible, this man is obviously a psychotic.
Moving on, the aircraft will be reaching their targets within the next hour, and we're in some very dire straits. If you look at the screen, it has nothing to do with the situation. Or anything, for that matter.
But I find this very difficult to understand. I thought I was the only one in authority to order the use of nuclear weapons.
And you'd be right, sir. However, General Ripper used the provisions of what is known as Plan R to its full effect.
Plan R?
Plan R is a emergency war plan in which a high-ranking Combine military official can order nuclear retaliation after a sneak attack, provided that the Citadel is being one of the affected targets. A majority of our leadership dismantled or killed, and the prospect that another force is gaining control over major Combine installations. It serves a purpose if all of the retaliatory safeguards fail, and the idea of a Combine sending over more reinforcements than Earth would either take more time or would be better than sending anything at all. Therefore, General Ripper did not need the highest command approval for such an order. The aircraft can receive no outside communication unless the message is preceded by the correct three-letter code that, unfortunately, only General Ripper knows.
Then we must send a communication to each target, put their securities and outside forces on full alert, and shoot down these planes.
That would be a sensible thing to do, sir. However, it's currently impossible. Ripper, being in charge of the one major communication outpost, has shut down, jammed, or blocked all of the important channels needed to get out any transmission. The only way to get out any kind of message is to re-enable the communications at the very site at which they were disabled.
So we need to get in contact with General Ripper now and stop this nonsense.
I'm afraid that's also impossible, sir. General Ripper has the entire outpost on condition red, with all communications on the inside base offline.
General Turgidson, our time is short, and we need to call off those planes. I am sick of your judgment on what is possible and impossible. Now we still have some alternatives left open to us. Now, are there any garrisons close to Ripper's location?
Mr. Administrator, the base I command is near that communications outpost.
Good. General Larinag, I want your troops to enter the base, locate General Ripper, and get the necessary communications sent out to those planes immediately in order to stop them.
Sir, if I may advise, when a base is on condition red, it is customary for their defenses to be on full alert and open fire on anything that comes near the base. Any opposing force would undergo some heavy casualties.
With all due respect, General, my troops can brush them aside without too much trouble.
Mr. Administrator, the Combine Overloader is trying to make contact with us here in the war room and wants to know what the fuss is about.
Damn it! What in the hell am I gonna say? Whatever. Send the communication through.
Survival kit content check. One pistol, submachine gun, stun stick, handheld radio, food and drink rations, Bible.
I don't need this Bible!
I find your lack of faith disturbing.
What's with that guy who sounds like James Earl Jones? Oh, that's Lieutenant Vader. When he became a Combine, the surgery screwed up his vocal cords a bit, so they had to make a special modification. And coincidentally, he sounds just like Darth Vader. And the only problem is, he pretends to be Vader.
We're having a little trouble with the connection. Just one moment, Mr. Administrator.
This situation is so unrealistic. Who in the hell invited us to the Sith convention anyway?
Hey there, Super Elite Killer Kappa Cup. What did you just say?
I said the situation is unrealistic, stupid, and I'm leaving.
Well, sorry. This isn't CS, but we have a general problem. And if you're saying CS is realistic, then you're even dumber than I thought.
My clan and our strategies could stop your rogue general in the blink of an eye. We wouldn't need a whole attack force. Shame they aren't here to show you.
Well, looky here. We have a real military genius. What do? Watch Full Metal Jacket 200 times and learn everything there is to know about urban combat?
Well, I say we have a better shot than you Gmod players that practice your camping skills in zombie survival.
Get back here, stupid offer.
Gentlemen, you can't fight in here. This is the war room. You can't fight in the war room because of all the wires and expensive things. I don't really want to kick anyone out of the war room, so just take it outside later, alright? How about we just take a moment to bow our heads for a quick prayer? Dear Lord, have we the fortune to carry on this mighty task, or are we all just jerking off?
Mr. Administrator, I think we've established successful contact with the Overlord.
You sure have to hand it to those rebels. They have Combine outfits and everything. I wonder where they got them from.
Yeah, they look like a real Combine attack squad. Okay, open fire on them after they cross that ridge.
I wonder what's going through his head right now.
I like potatoes. And if you put some sour cream on it.
Would you check your Steam MySpace page later? You called us! Okay, what happened is one of our commanding generals went a little funny in the head. You know, no, not funny like a clown. Yes, I think clowns are funny too. Except for Pogo the Clown, he's a rapist. Anyway, what this general did was order an air attack on some of our own big-time nuclear weapon installations. He proceeded to block all the Combine channels in order to send out a signal to stop the bombers, and we can't get in contact with the outpost that's jamming our signal. Well, how do you think I feel about it? Why do you suppose we're talking, just to say hello? Well, of course I like to speak to you. Of course I like to say hello. Listen, all we have to do is take the communications outpost from the general by force and send out the necessary signals from his base. And from there, we can either call the planes back if we get the recall code, or we'll just have to shoot them down ourselves. All right, well, we're sending you all the maps and plans of the fighters so you can see for yourself as we speak. Okay, here they come now. Sorry. Establish connection again if you need to. I love you too.
Hey
genuine Counter-Strike para. I wanted to buy the op, but the goddamn dynamic pricing is enabled on this server. We could have won this war a long time ago if the Combine had some decent generals. Hopefully my plan will bring out the best and send all the rebels to their doom. Now our men need some help against the rebels, and I need you to carry some extra ammo for me. So come on, we're going to the roof.
I don't think that's such a good idea. Wait, sir, let's have a chat first. How did you come up with your plan?
Well, I got the idea while browsing the internets. And I had one hand on the keyboard and the other on my...
Alright, never mind, sir. We better get going to the roof.
Then don't stall me. Now I'll aim for the guy with the bomb. No rebel is going to be planting anything except flowers at their fallen comrades' graves.
Mr. Administrator, we were able to send a number of scouts to various bases and inform them of the situation. We've located over half the planes on their bombing run, and as a failsafe, we should be able to fire long-range missiles at them. We're getting a lot of our communications back, but still nothing in reach of that communications outpost.
Laronegg, I sure hope your men make haste. You, I want all helicopters, dropships, and other aircraft grounded immediately. Make sure nothing else takes off. And you, can you make me a peanut butter sandwich? Oh, and, can you cut the crust off that, please? Thanks.
Sir?
Okay, fire on the planes.
Gear is to a bigger penis.
Machine gun for your precious bodily fluids. Die, you terrorist rebels. Come on, Mandrake. Let's get back inside.
Sir, Lieutenant Will reporting, sir. We can't push forward till we can clear out that section of the roof, sir.
All right, then. I've got an idea. Send in the Boomsday Machine.
Couldn't we just, use grenades, sir?
Let's just use grenades. Soldiers! Fire at will!
Hey, what the fuck?
No! The roof! Throw them on the roof, soldiers!
Why did it get quiet? Did we lose? Those hackers. I can't believe we lost the fight against those rebels before the bombers hit their targets.
I'm sure they gave it their very best, sir. Now since we've lost, would you please give me the recall code so I can call off the squadron? Going to take a leak? Good idea. I'll wait here. May I guess what the code is and... Is there something wrong with the toilet, sir? Are you still with me? Oh, good God!
Citizens of City 17, I would like to make a request that if you see any aircraft, report the location and the direction of where it is headed immediately. We have a group of highly trained professionals working hard to prevent what could be a major dilemma.
What the fuck, people?
That was my bad. But it was the terrorists who started it, though, I swear!
Alright, all you mod villains have got to go. Everybody leave. None of you guys are getting along, so exit in an orderly fashion. You too, Hitler.
Aww.
Well, boys, we're halfway to our target.
Fire!
Major Kong, we have a missile tracking us.
Oh, shoot. Fly along between that bridge. See if we can lose it. I wonder if he was anyone important.
Go up! Go up! Missile's gonna hit us!
prepare for impact! Holy shit!
Where's the fire extinguisher? Go get the fire extinguisher!
Pal, I need you to activate the sprinkler system so we can get these fires out.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Ow, ow, fire hot! Ow, ow!
Those grenades! What the hell? Secure the area!
This has been the finest course of convoy military action I've seen in my entire career.
Minus the Boobs Day machine.
Well, yeah.
And the fact that we're invading one of our own bases.
Shut up.
Stop right there, you deviative prevert!
Pervert?
Prevert, I need to speak to a General Ripper about getting a recall code. Where is he?
I've been trying to figure it out too, and the only person who knows the code is General Ripper, and he's killed himself in the bathroom.
Killed himself in the bathroom? How do I know you had nothing to do with it?
That is absurd.
Who wrote on the wall here? What's this? On the wall here is the recall code. RGW.
Over there! Hey, let him go, I got it!
You found the recall code?
Yes, it's RGW. Can we alert Dr. Breen?
We're still having some trouble with communications, so we might not be able to send the message to the Citadel.
Someone will have to go on foot then.
But there's hardly any time.
Go report to the commander, and I'll see what I can do with the communications.
All the radio gear is out, including the CRM-114. The auto-destruct mechanism is damaged.
The fire is out. The emergency power is on.
We're losing fuel. However, we will still be able to reach the primary target, but we will not make it back to base. So we'll have to bail out afterwards.
Yeah, boys, we're losing power. The radio's gone, we're leaking fuel, and if we's flying any lower, why, we need hover pulse on this thing. They might shoot us from this height, but they dang sure ain't gonna spot us on no radar. So you need to deliver the code to the Citadel on foot, eh? Well, I just happen to have here a genuine flying airboat at the ready, and I'll deliver it straight to the Citadel. Don't you soldiers worry about me, I'll be back in a flash.
Wait!
Does he realize the Citadel is that way?
Who cares? Doesn't matter anymore. We got the message out to the Citadel.
Then our job here is done. Hey, how do you suppose they built the Citadel anyway?
I think they built a miniature of it, placed it off the map somewhere, and then they projected it to that location and resized it.
That's just ridiculous.
Well, that does it, Mr. Administrator. None of the planes were called back, and the other three were shot down.
See? There were alternatives left open to us.
Hold it, Mr. Administrator. The Overlord is establishing contact again, and he's hopping mad.
Huh, that's funny. I didn't know he could hop.
Fuel loss is increasing. It doesn't look like we'll be able to reach the primary target.
Damn it, Goldie. You told me we'd still be able to reach the main target.
That was based on the original fuel loss estimate. We're losing fuel so fast we won't be able to make it to the primary target. However, we will be able to reach the secondary target.
What kind of target is that anyhow?
It's a central control outpost for firing contained headcrabs and shells at the bases.
Set the headcrab shell and control center as the new target and change course.
You know what he says? He says he's been watching the action from a satellite and one of the planes hasn't turned back. He says it was fired on, but only damaged, and the plane changed course to a brand new target. Okay, I'll ask him. Is Dr. Strangeman still here? We need to know if he knows anything about the Headcrab Shelling Control Center.
Moment please, Mr. Administrator. Things that bother you never bother me. I'm as happy as pie. Ha ha! Living in the sunlight, loving in the moonlight, having a wonderful time. Let's begin. As chief of weapon development for the Combine, I authorize the creation of such a building. The Shelling Control Center is an outpost we built in the aftermath of the portal storms as the main control center for sending over dozens of headcrabs, packing them up in shells and launching them into rebel strongholds so we can clear them out without sending any foot soldiers. Quite amusing, really.
So is there a serious risk if this thing is destroyed?
Yes. The Combine set up a giant link that connects all of our vital military and communication centers. If one center is destroyed or overrun within 24 hours of the plan or order, there would be an automatic trigger mechanism that essentially sends City 17 into an irreversible doom.
Please explain.
In order to persuade the rebels not to attack our most important and subtle installations, the Combine made a special auto-destruct mechanism that would set off buried nuclear devices in the city, depending on the situation. The point of having this mechanism was to give the rebels the fear of attacking these targets, and with the consequential burden of their potentially dangerous actions against them, it would trigger this very Armageddon. But that very point was lost. In this moment of truth.
From here.
Because you kept it a secret. Why didn't you tell it to City 17 on your TV show, eh?
Why, that mechanism's just ridiculous. Sounds like a perfectly good reason to attack it from a minge bag's point of view.
If we put all the forces we can into the area and aim at it, we can't miss it. Doesn't matter if they're flying too low to be visible on radar, we know where it's going. Send a communication to that outpost immediately and tell them to shoot down the first aircraft they see.
Sir. Something's already approaching on our radar.
That must be it. Let's go! Troops, the target is approaching.
What the hell is that thing? I expected the aircraft to be bigger than that.
Wait, you're yapping. Troops, take aim! And... fire!
You know, in my entire military combine career, ever since the surgery, I've always wanted one last thing. That's a peanut butter jelly sandwich. Why can't I just have a peanut butter jelly sandwich?
Approaching target. Bombs at the ready.
Now, open the bomb bay doors.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
You jerk. Goldie, set the bomb doors on manual override. I'm going down to get them open. You fellas stay on the bomb run.
Roger that.
We have shot down the flying airboat as ordered.
Wait, a flying airboat? Hold on, let's just backtrack for just a minute here.
Target in sight! Where in the hell is Major Kahn?
Bomb bay doors are open.
Bombs our way!
Hey, what about Major Kahn?
I don't understand. You gave us orders.
What the heck?
What the hell was that? Oh, you have gotta be kidding me! Those dumb bastards shot the wrong thing down first and didn't bother to look for what followed! Dr. Strangeman, what's going to happen presuming that a nuclear bomb just hit that building? Will that activate the trigger mechanism?
I'm afraid so. Time to start weighing, Mr. Administrator. In the next 30 minutes, we'll begin a series of nuclear explosions all over City 17 that will continue throughout the next 10 days. It will become so bad in the forthcoming weeks that life on Earth will be inhospitable. Chances of survival for most people are next to none. But look on the bright side, Mr. Administrator. Those rebels are fucked!
So, are we safe here in the Citadel?
Unfortunately, no. The radiation and other deadly off-planet foreign elements from the dirty bombs will contaminate the entire atmosphere of Earth. These bombs, sent over by overlords, were a safeguard in case the Combine ever lost control of the planet, and it would eradicate all life on Earth from all the urban areas spanning the globe in retaliation. Seeing as how most of us don't want to take another host body to teleport off-planet, we do still have one option. Relocating into some of our deepest mine shafts, radioactivity or other gases could never penetrate that far beneath the surface. With a ratio of 10 males to each female...
Gangbang!
Sorry, 10 females to each male. The human race can replenish its numbers. There is still time to alert the other cities.
Well, we have to act fast.
Mr. Administrator, I think we need to look at this from a military point of view. Suppose a number of rebels follow us down and continue their insurgency. Why, if we let our guard down, they could take over. We still need food, and especially weapons. Can't forget weapons. And the research has to extend to all the mine shafts. Mr. Administrator, we must not allow a mine shaft gap!
Wait! I have a plan.
Mine gap! I can walk!
Not anymore, you can't.
Hitler! Oh, you!
Again, don't know where, don't know where.